Perfect, everyone. Thanks very much for joining us here once again today. I'm going to just wait for a few people to start joining us. And to those who have started joining us, thank you very much for being with us this evening once again. Well, good morning, good afternoon, good evening to all of you, wherever you're joining from in the world. We are talking about a very, very important project for international university sports today. And it is something that FISU has undertaken over the last 1.5 years or so. It's in fact one of the most important and potentially impactful projects that FISU has taken up in a long, long time. And as we wait for the FISU Secretary General Eric Saintrond to join us this evening, let me just give those of you who don't know too much about Healthy Campus a quick run through of what the project is. So the FISU Healthy Campus project is really the FISU Healthy Campus label, an objective, an aim, an endeavor to try and instill very good positive lifestyle habits on campus cultures around the world, which means embedding lifestyle, well-being, health on university campuses everywhere in the world. Now, of course, you would say that is a very tall task because we are talking about impacting all the millions of university students out there. So just how is FISU planning to go ahead and implement this project? And what is really the potential scope of this project? That's exactly what we are going to be talking to Eric Saintrond about. And he should be joining us any minute now. So we're going to start welcoming Eric for taking out his time and being with us here today. Eric Saintrond, Secretary General, CEO of FISU. Thank you very much for joining us.
Good afternoon, good morning for some of you, and maybe a good night for some of you as well, because I believe that we have people far away from Switzerland.
That's right. We have people from around the world joining us, Eric. So I hope you're ready for a lot of questions and that, you know, you've had a good week, that we know there's a lot of work going on in FISU behind the scenes, even though we are all working from home. We're not working in the office. But the gentleman you see on your screens is making sure everything is running smoothly behind the scenes. And one of our biggest projects, Eric, is coming up. And I'd like to start directly with that. The FISU Healthy Campus project is something that was launched, was being discussed. In fact, around the time I joined FISU, this was around September 2018. And now this project is ready for a launch in 12 days. So can you tell us what the process has been like from the idea and why it was conceived, why FISU decided to do this to where we are today, where we're looking to launch this massive project on a scale that's probably not been seen before?
Yes, thank you. The project was born actually a long time ago, as you say. But as everyone knows, we had to move our office from Belgium to Switzerland, and from Switzerland we moved from one office to another one, and that took us a couple of years as well to relocate our FISU headquarters in Lausanne. And at the same time, with more or less today 75% of the staff were new people. I mean, they were not in Belgium, or they were not even at the beginning of our first office in Switzerland. Then, of course, we had different priorities, even if the project was already in our mind. And we have also to try to find a way through this project to extend our activities, not only to elite students, athletes, but to all students in general. At the same time, we believe that FISU has a very important social responsibility, and not only focusing on only dozens of thousands of students, which is more or less the number of athletes that are participating in our events every 2 years, but on all students in the world. Means that we are talking about nearly in the future, they are talking about 2025, about 200 million people.
Yes.
And of course, the health problems that we are facing in our modern society is of course duplicated in the, as well in our students' community. We're talking about obesity, stress, addictions, and so on. And therefore, we strongly believe that today we can motivate the academic authorities to pay a bit more attention to the health and the healthy lifestyle of our students.
And that's really what is unique about FISU, isn't it, Derek? The fact that because we are education and sport, we're in that position to be able to talk to these universities and motivate them, as you said. But you also talked about the number just now, and you talked about potentially impacting 150 to 200 million university students around the world. So I have to ask you, in an ideal scenario, can this happen? And how realistic is this possibility of really being able to reach out to each one of those 200 million students?
You know, we have more than 40,000 universities in the world. And if you reach only 1% of those universities, means that you are reaching 400 to 500 universities and on the five continents. Mean that if you look at the number of students in each and every big universities, there are between 20,000 to 50,000 people. Mean that with 1% of the universities in the world,
yes,
we can already engage millions of students in our program. Of course, I'm not talking about 200 million, but a couple of million certainly.
Okay.
And of course, it will take time to develop this project, but it's not a short-term project. It's not even not a medium-term project. It's a long-term investment that we are starting now, 12th of May.
Yeah, exactly. I think that's what needs to be understood best, because this project is really hoping to impact public health in a significant way. And these kind of projects take time, and they're not something that happen overnight. But it's important to understand right now, Eric, you know, you talked about even if we get 1% of those universities, and that's a really great point, we reach out to a huge number of students. But why should the university sign up for this program? If I'm a university rector or if I'm a university decision maker, what's in it for me that I should join this Healthy Campus program?
But today we have already, as you know, seven universities that are part of our pilot project. And we are not talking about small universities. We are talking about University of Western Australia. We are talking about Johannesburg in South Africa. We are talking about Torino University in Italy, RUDN in Moscow University, the University of Matanzas in Argentina, 50,000 students. And of course, the University of Lausanne, where we have already a large development of promotion of healthy lifestyle on the campus. And then, of course, to convince those universities was already a first step. And by signing up this program, the universities will finally enter a network that is not existing globally today, and certainly not covering so many fields of actions, because we are talking about physical activity and sport, nutrition, disease prevention, mental and social health, risk behavior, environment, sustainability, and social responsibility. And that there is no program in the world existing like this.
Yes.
And thanks to the access to this Healthy Campus network, the universities will be able to share experience, to share best practices, to evaluate as well and compare, because we have 100 criteria that they have to fulfill, to evaluate and compare the level of engagement in those fields. And of course, this is a way to progress very quickly in that kind of program.
Okay, so not only does it give them a toolkit and guidelines to actually implement these healthy practices, but the real value is that international network that you talk of, where they will be able to share knowledge with best universities around the world. And that's as good a reason as any for universities to join this program. So before we go ahead with a few more questions on this, Eric, I've had some questions come in for you from our viewers, from our audience, from people who follow FISU on various social networks. So I'm going to take some of our viewer questions now. These are not necessarily about Healthy Campus, but, you know, some general questions about university sport, which I'm sure you'd be happy to answer. So what the first question that's come in is, certainly this has to be about the COVID-19 situation. What are the plans if even by September things are not back to normal?
Well, very honestly, we have already anticipated this. Probably we were the first federation in the world, international federation, to put their staff or staff in home working from the 13th of March, knowing that it will take time. Then it gives us the time to prepare ourselves to the home working and the long-term home working. This home working will be prolonged till the end of June. And we know already today, because the situation is changing every week, that it could be that our staff will remain in home working in July and August.
Yeah.
The key point is that we have to cancel already 13 championships this year. And of course, FISU organizing committees of championships are not, you know, big organizing committee with a lot of resources. And for them was a lot of work to put this in place. And of course, what a very bad news to have to cancel this. But they were obliged to do it, even by the government. I mean that what we expect today is that we will not have to cancel the championship that we left from September to December. But we don't know today. It could be that we will be forced to cancel all World Youth Championships. And then our idea is to try to postpone them to 21. But due to the fact that so many federations had to cancel their major events, and the big federation as well, of course, the sport calendar in 21 will be amazing and very packed. Yeah. And if we can find some space in the sports calendar, we will try to do it. But anyway, I'm not very optimistic that we will find in 21 enough space in the calendar to move off world championships.
Okay, well, yes, I mean, the thing is that, you know, things are so uncertain right now that we can't really say, but thank you for clarifying what you could at the moment. We've also got questions coming in live from our viewers who are with us right now, Eric, so I'll start taking some of those questions. Albinella, I will take your question a bit later because it's similar to one of the questions I'm going to ask as well. But someone has asked, Eric, can you tell us what you think might change at university sports in general, after this pandemic finishes? What changes will we see?
Well, we have made some survey among our member association, and all of them, in all countries, the campus were closed.
Yeah.
And then, of course, it's opened the door to how to organize the education system in the future for universities. When I visited a city in Mexico a long time ago, it was Monterrey, I found out that they had a fantastic online educational program, because the kids in Mexico not able sometimes to travel to Monterrey. Mm-hmm. And it was very professional already, and it was probably more than 10 to 12 years ago. And I believe that in the future, probably more universities will develop those kind of courses, because it's cheaper, it's more efficient, and at the end, people can manage their life a bit differently. And for the university sports as well, because if you are an athlete, you have to train, maybe you can get your classes online and then manage your agenda a bit better to be able to practice, to train, to go to competitions. Regarding the university sports at the national level, of course, it's complicated, because most of national federation depends, of course, on the activities on the campuses. Yeah. And if there was no students practicing sports on the campus, it's more complicated to organize competition between faculties or between different universities. But yeah, this is something that will be a second step. But my feeling is that the system of education could be adapted afterwards.
Yes, it probably will be. And, you know, we're seeing so many changes, as you said, in the way we work, with so many virtual meetings and things like that. So every area of life is being impacted. And we're, in fact, going to be starting a few virtual challenges here on FISU as well. Just a shout out to all of you to stay tuned. We have some really exciting stuff coming up in the next few weeks, where we will have virtual challenges for football, for cheerleading, for basketball, 3x3. So lots of good stuff in store. There's a question from Christian, who has written in to ask you, Eric, what support has FISU provided to NUSS during this pandemic?
Well, the support is there to communicate with them, but it's not so easy, because, as you know, this pandemic affected the country differently. Even between Switzerland, mm-hmm. France and Belgium, the government has taken different decisions regarding containment, regarding the security in the public transportation and so on. Meaning that what we did is try to inform them about the situation in all countries member of FISU. Then we have distributed the information that what was the situation in each and every country member of FISU. Unfortunately, not everyone replied. As always, sometimes they are not really...
Well, it happens.
Very proactive. And in terms of financial support, of course, it's not possible for FISU to support all national federation. What we did is that for the organizing committees of the World Championship that have been canceled, yeah, we have reserved some funds to compensate the expenses. Then, of course, we will reimburse the organizing rights, but at the same time, we will as well try to help them by giving them a sum of money to compensate the work that has been done. But it's clear that all the national federation depends on their government. It means that most of the time, they need to have the funding from their government.
Yeah.
That's the only thing we can do today.
Absolutely. And I, you know, we've been in touch with some of the organizing committees, and they're extremely thankful for this kind of support that FISU has in fact given them. So, you know, I hope that answers your question, Christian. Now I have a few rapid fire questions for you, Eric, just to get to know you and your sporting preferences a little bit more. The only rule here is that you have to give me the first thing that comes to mind without thinking about your answer too much. Agreed? Okay, so we start. What's your favorite FISU sport?
Well, I like all sports, and I can say that there's one particular sport that I like more than another one. Each and every sport has some specificity that make that all of them are interesting for me.
Okay. Okay, fine. I'll let that one pass. The best host city of the World University Games, formerly known as Universiad, that you have seen?
I cannot answer this because I don't want to make enemies. But very honestly, each and every games have a special flavor. It's not only the best organization in terms of best venues, best technical officials, best transportation system, and so on. It's just how also the participants, that is very important for us, how the athletes and the students get a good experience of those games and fantastic souvenir from their experience in the country. Then the cultural aspect is extremely important.
Well, I've been at two and they both have been fantastic. So I agree with you on that one. But you talked about the souvenir, so I have to ask you. And this one, I will not accept a diplomatic answer. What has been your favorite mascot of all time?
I've seen so many mascots. But mascot is not something very new, because we started with the mascot in the world of sports not so long time ago. But for me, it was the mascot from the Zagreb 1987 games.
Okay.
Why? Because it's the name was Zagi, and it was a coral, and I like it because my son, my oldest son, was born in May 1988. He was a couple of months old, and when I brought this mascot from Zagreb, it was his favorite mascot, and certainly his very first teddy toy as well.
Okay, so that's a good reason. And so finally, one city or country that you would like to see a future FISU event or a future FISU World University Games in, which has not hosted a FISU event before?
Well, everyone knows that I'm very much supporting the idea to have finally won the games in Africa. Mm-hmm. I've been to South Africa a couple of times. So President Oleg Matitsin has been to South Africa as well. We have visited also other countries, and our dream will be to come to Africa for the games. It will be not so easy. Today, there is not so many countries that will be able to do it. But if you see the Youth Olympic Games going to Senegal, maybe Senegal could be a good place to go as well.
Right.
For the Youth Olympic Games. And now, after that, I have a second dream that you will love, is to go to India.
Yes, I'm hoping for that.
And we count on you for your lobbying.
Yes, yes, for sure. We're going to make that happen, I promise you. Okay, so I have a question actually that's coming right now. Razi Faj has asked about the dual career situation, and I'm going to quickly answer that for you. We just keep watching the FISU website over the next few weeks. It's FISU.net, if you don't already know. And we, in fact, have a major resource and a special page dedicated to dual career, which will be coming up soon. So you will get all your answers on that page.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. Now, coming back to the Healthy Campus, Eric, you know, personally, from your point of view, what is your objective from this project? You already told us it's a long-term project, but let's say 5 years or 6 years in the future, what will make you look back and say, okay, this is what we set out to achieve, and I can call this a successful project today?
Well, I believe that we will be able to say that we were successful when FISU will be recognized by the students' community and the academic authorities as an important partner for the promotion of the well-being of all students. And this is our target. I mean, we do not, the number of universities that will be part of the project is, of course, important. But if we are at least recognized by this, and if the FISU Healthy Campus label is recognized, for us, it will be already a great achievement.
Okay, so the label is something that the universities and students should hopefully aspire to in the future. And
exactly.
To be prone
to get it.
Yes, exactly.
And to maintain it, because they will not get the label for the rest of their life. Every 2 years, they will be evaluated and so on, and we have a follow-up of this.
Yes, exactly. We are going to be sharing all the information about the Healthy Campus project over the next 2 weeks leading up to the launch. And stay tuned to all the FISU channels to get all this information that Eric is talking about, exactly how to register, how it works, how universities will earn the label. All that information will be on it. Very recently, Eric, we spoke with Oleg Matitsin, the FISU president, and he, in fact, said that during the strange time of lockdown, during COVID-19, is actually, in a way, a good time to launch the Healthy Campus project. Can you explain that a little bit further?
Yeah. Today, as I mentioned, before everyone... today, everyone has been affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, not only one region or one country. And for me, it's the first time that all the universities, not only one country or one region in the world,
yeah,
had to manage a problem that is above their daily responsibility. Because the responsibility of the campus, I could see that as well on the campus in Lausanne, admitting with the vice rectors and so on, they didn't know exactly what to do. Of course, they locked down, they closed the campus. It was the easiest way. But afterwards, we have to organize the courses, try to find solutions for the exam and so on. And it is the first time that they had to face that kind of situation, not in one part of the world, but all around the world. And of course, now... if you have no players, you can have not have a team to play. If you have no students, you cannot have a university. That means that now, I believe that thanks to the Healthy Campus, it's all universities are now focusing on the health problems. And it's the right moment to use this pandemic to just to explain what we are planning to do in the future. And because everyone is now focusing on the health of the students, and not only the students, I'm talking about the university committee, including the professor, the assistant, all the workers working on the campus. It's a huge community, because if we have 20,000 students in Lausanne, we have also the same number of people working in different areas. I believe the president was right. It's the right moment to launch this project. And we can develop it online, then there is no problem.
And that's the greatest strength of this project, that it doesn't need people to be physically on the campus while the development stage goes on, right? So universities can actually prepare for this, and perhaps they will be ready in time to welcome the students as they come in for the new academic session by September.
Yeah, and even the students will be a bit more motivated, because now I understood that to be... In containment in a small apartment, not to be able to move, to train themselves, to go to run somewhere, they will probably have also more wishes to practice more sport activities and to have a better lifestyle as well.
Okay. Well, there's a question that's related to this that's come in, which is who will be evaluating the Healthy Campus criteria? Once again, I can quickly let you know that all these details about the Healthy Campus project will be available on all of the FISU social media platforms, as well as the FISU website over the next 2 weeks. And all details about exactly what the criteria are and how they're going to be evaluated, you will be able to find all the information. But thank you for your question in any case.
Anyway, you can mention that we have all the criteria were not coming from the head of the director of the Healthy Campus program. Yeah. It was supported by 30 experts from different horizons, and all of them have contributed dramatically in the establishment of the 100 criteria. It's not only one person, it's 30 experts.
Yeah, It's a large team of international experts, as I had said right in my introduction, and it's an extremely complex document which has been prepared over several months, and all details will be available soon. But you talk of experts, Eric, and that's actually my next question. This is the kind of project that this is. This has a huge potential impact on public health, on global health. So are other major international organizations involved or on board in any way with FISU on this?
Yeah, but of course, we have already the first ambassadors will be the seven pilot universities, because as I mentioned, they are very big universities, and of course, they have an important voice in their own country, mm-hmm. but and out of the country as well. But of course, we have in our group of expert people from UNESCO. We have got already some feedback from World Health Organization, and we had some meetings with them. Of course, however, today, you can believe that WHO has many other things to do than to talk about Healthy Campus. Yes. But it's clear that they're very interested in the program, because it's not so easy to enter the campus and to enter the universities. It's a, yes. it's a very, very close world. And but it is clear that we have already a great feedback from the even the, from the IOC. And I believe that very soon, when the project will be launched with the open to all universities, we will have a huge interest from all major organizations in the world.
Yes, exactly. And like you mentioned, you know, if there is any time where the world's focus is on health, it is right now. So in that sense, it's probably perfect timing for us to be going ahead with this project. Some more questions before we wind up, Eric. We've got some more questions coming in from our live viewers right now. And one of them asks, coming back to our calendar, asks about whether the World University Cheer and Dance event will take place this year or not. I think this is probably more of a general question as to whether the World University Championships in the last 3 months or so of the year, will they take place according to you?
Yeah, today we still don't know, because as I told you, the situation is changing every week, and we don't want to cancel anything. And anyway, we not cancel, we source the full cooperation with the organizing committees. But all the program after September will be decided probably in the month of May. This okay. month, we will have to evaluate the situation and to see if the government allow the people to travel. Because yes. it's not only to organize. You have to understand, if you have a world championship, you have to move people from Asia, from Europe, from Americas, from Africa, from Oceania. And sometimes, and you can see the situation today with the airline companies, some of them will not be able to travel. Some of them will not be allowed to travel. And that's what we have to evaluate before taking a final decision.
Yeah, well, I mean, and that's the thing. The global situation is so uncertain right now. It really depends on what happens internationally with travel and various other things before we can have any sort of confirmed answer on that.
The only event that we have postponed to 21 is the final of the 3-on-3 basketball. Not because it's in China or because we are afraid that the people could not come to the final. It's because the participants to the 3-on-3 final in 3-on-3 are selected during the continental games and continental championships. But unfortunately, yeah. all those competitions have been canceled in 2020. Then we could not have the team select. That's why we canceled this 3-on-3 in 20, and we postpone it to next year in 21.
Absolutely. And as we wind up, there's one question that has come in from a lot of viewers, Eric, so we can conclude with this. It's about Lucerne 2021 and Chengdu 2021, the two World University Games that will take place next year. Is FISU thinking about any sort of contingency plan in relation to these events regarding the current pandemic in the world?
Of course, we have always a contingency plan, because it would be stupid not to have it. But we are convinced that today, seeing the development in Switzerland, the games, we have no problem in January 2021 for the winter in Lucerne. And with Chengdu, we will be just after the Olympic Games. Mm-hmm. And I believe that if we have to cancel Chengdu Games, means that the Olympic Games in Tokyo will be canceled as well, because both of them will be there.
Yeah.
But we are very, we are really convinced. We had a long discussion with the mayor of Chengdu last week. He's very supportive. The situation in China, of course, is also changing every week, but they have already taken the control of the situation in China. And China is a huge country. The place where we go, it was not the most affected place in China. And today, we have no reason to think that all games in winter, for the winter games and the summer game, we could have some problems.
Okay, well, as of now, that's the best case scenario as of now. And let's hope things don't change too much. So thanks very much for taking out the time, Eric. And I think it would be nice if you could conclude with maybe a message or some words to university students about what FISU is hoping to do with the Healthy Campus project.
Well, just to, so I could convince everyone, I will just repeat some words from the rectors of the University of Lausanne. She said, Eric, you will be successful with Healthy Campus if you can convince my best students in mathematics that are not practicing any activities, that if they practice some activities, they will be even much better. And she's right. I mean, physical activities, a good healthy lifestyle can improve not only your health, but also your brain.
Yeah.
That's my conclusion.
Exactly. So I hope all the students out there listen to that advice. And if we can get the ones who are not so much into activity and sport to start moving, that's really the objective of this project. It launches on the 12th of May. It's going to be huge in scope and potential impact. So we really hope all of you are going to partner us in this. All the universities, all the university students, be part of this and join this great movement that will be starting in just under 2 weeks from now. And for the moment, thank you very much to the Secretary General CEO of FISU, Eric Saintrond.
And take care and stay home.
Stay home. That's right. Thank you. Thanks, bye-bye, everyone. Thank you all for joining. Thanks very much.